Hi, it's Nurse Jessica Afenomi, and today I'm going to be talking about
understanding how to write
the near perfect pathophysiology. Pathophysiology is basically the study of abnormal changes that will happen in the body in the presence of a disease. The key to writing the perfect pathophysiology without cramming is understanding the normal. Say it for the people in the back seat. If you do not know what normally happens in that particular system and they give you a disease in the system, you'll be stranded. You will not know what to write. You will not be trying to cram everything before the exam, which will not help you. You also check like your med surg slides. You will notice that if they are talking about diseases of the respiratory system, they start the slide by giving an overview of what the respiratory system is. So if you understand the anatomy and physiology of the respiratory system, you might not even have to read pathophysiology at all in the textbook. It just comes up in your brain. You just know because you understand what the normal is. There's a guide I use. So if I were to describe the pathophysiology of asthma, I'll first start by saying under normal circumstances, air flows through bronchi. The bronchi has mucous membranes around it, and this mucous membrane produces little amount of mucus to be able to trap particles that have come with the air so it doesn't go inside and cause an infection. And then that bronchi is normally like dilated, open wide for air to flow. When there's a trigger, and that trigger could be genetics, it could be environmental factors, it could be exercise, whatever causes that asthma is still going to follow the same pathophysiology. When it enters the bronchi, mast cells in the body will now start an inflammatory reaction. Imagine that the bronchi was like this before. Then it now gets inflamed. As it's getting inflamed, it's reducing in size. So it's becoming very small. So you that you are breathing normally when the bronchi was like this, if you now get like this, you'll be suffocating and gasping for air. So that's literally what asthma is. So now that there's inflammation in the bronchi, I already know that if there's inflammation, there's pain. If there's inflammation, there will be redness. If there's inflammation, the function that used to happen before will no longer be, and it will now be like different. So I just incorporate all those things and I make it a pathophysiology. This video cannot explain everything about pathophysiology, but just to tell you that if you've been struggling with pathophysiology, you probably do not understand what the normal is. So this is a challenge to nursing students. Go and read your systems. Go back and understand your cardiovascular system, your respiratory system, your musculoskeletal system, every system in the body. The systems are not up to 20. So literally just take one in a week or one in 2 weeks, depending on your pace. Don't rush yourself. Understand the system. If you have understood the system, there's no disease in this life that you cannot try to figure out. You might not get the thing 100%, but 80%. And also, if you can learn the inflammation process to go a long way in nursing, see a lot of diseases happen through inflammation. And especially all those diseases that they will end with IITs. It's not every disease in this life with IITs that is inflammation. But 95% of diseases with IITs are inflammation. If you don't know the normal pathophysiology, just formulate something with the inflammation process and you are going to get your answer. If you've understood this video by now, you should know that the equation is number one, you write the normal. Number two, you add the cause. Number three, you now write the abnormal. What happens when that cause enters? Number four, you add the signs and symptoms. Number five, add the complication. Attached to this video in the link below is a pathophysiology that I did for an assignment. And if you check it, you'll see that all these things I'm mentioning are there. See, I read cardiovascular system like 20 times. I'm not even joking, because it had to enter. Sometimes to challenge myself, I used to read about the system. Then I browse a disease under the system. So if I'm reading about the cardiovascular system, I now go and I check, oh, endocarditis, that's inflammation of the endocardium. So what was the function of that endocardium? I write it down. What will now happen as a change in that endocardium? I try to formulate my own pathophysiology. Then I compare it to like what I get from the internet. And I'm like, wow, I think I'm actually doing well. Okay, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video to other nursing students because we need to help each other, guys.